Hello students, today we are going to start our next topic, that is subject and predicate. As every sentence contains two parts, subject and predicate. Subject means it tells us whom or what a sentence is about, and predicate what is said about the subject. In other words, it can be the subject is who and the predicate tells what the subject does. For example, the big green frog jumped across the log. Who jumped across the log? That is the big green frog. That is a subject. And what the subject did? Jumped across the log. That is a predicate. Predicate contains at least a verb. See the example over here. Aman and Rajat study in the same school. Here study, that is a verb. That is a predicate. Study in the same school is the predicate. A sentence may contain a subject and a verb only. For example, they won. Here they is a subject and won is a predicate, which is only a verb. Coming to the next is, they won the football match easily. Here they is a subject, won the football match easily is the predicate. A subject can also be made of more than one word. A huge animal with the big ears broke the fence. That is a huge animal with the big ears. That is a subject. To determine the subject of a sentence, first isolate the verb, then make a question by placing who or what. You will get the answer. It is not always in the starting of sentence. It can be in the middle also. See the example over here. During the storm, the electricity went out. What went out? The electricity. That is a subject over here. There were two dogs playing outside the house. Who play outside the house? That is two dogs. That is the subject over here. Coming to the next, in the case of interrogative sentence, the subject usually appears after a helping verb and before the main verb. See example over here. Where are you going? Are is a helping verb. Going is a main verb. You is a subject over here. See one more example. Will the players reach the stadium on time? Will is a helping verb. Reach is a main verb. The players, that is the subject over here. When we make request or give command, the sentence may not have a subject. Bring the cat here, please. One more example. Clean your room. A command is being given. No subject is being there. It is automatically to the person to whom we are talking. So here the subject is you. Tell me a story. You tell me a story. The subject is not there, but it is understood that to whom we are talking, who is a person to whom we are giving the command or a request or an order. Every sentence has a subject or a predicate. There may be more than one subject in the sentence. See the example over here. Judy and her dog run on the beach every morning. Who run? That is Judy and her dog. That is known as compound subjects. So, a sentence may have compound subjects in it. Here the example you can see. Her uncle and she walked slowly through the art gallery. Okay, her uncle and she both are the subject. So, the difference between the subject and the predicate is subject tells who or whom, predicate the action done. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you.